Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the next episode on this tutorial series. Well, in this episode, we are going to have a look how we are actually creating movement over the network. So basically, the goal right here is that we are sending the key input from the client to the server. The server will take this key input and it converts it to actual movement and moves the player on the server. After he's done that, he will send back the positional data from the server to everyone who is connected. So you will be able to see how the player is moving and by just sending key input from Unity to our dedicated server. So I would say without further ado, we are going to start right away. I have to mention, if you like this video, please leave a comment, hit the thumbs up, and if you want to chat with me as well, go check out my Discord server. You will see all links down below in the description. You can download my new updated DLL file, which will be open source very soon, on my homepage. Also, you can see the link down below in the description. And yeah, now, without further ado, let's start right away. Okay, we are starting with the Unity client, first of all, where we left it a couple of days ago. Excuse me, my language, though. So yeah, we are going to start right away with the client and open up the, well, any script, because we have to create a new script within Unity. So in Unity, we are right-clicking and add a new class, which will be a C# monobehavior class, and we call this class Input Manager. Within this Input Manager, we are going to create the magic. So first of all, we want to have an enum or list with all keys we want to press, okay, or which a player is allowed to press. So therefore, we are going to create a public enum and call this keys. And now we are thinking what keys he should press. Well, in this case, the key none, obviously, which will be the default key, since we also want to have a state where the player did not press any key. Then, of course, as usual, W, A, and S, and D. So all these keys we want to press to move the player. Okay, forwards, backwards, left, right, it doesn't matter. Okay, as next, we are going to create a public variable, which will be public keys, and we call this pressed key. Okay, perfect. So in our start method, we want to make sure that pressed key is equal to keys.none. So the state of the player will be always, when he is connecting or getting instantiated, will be that he's not pressing a key, else when he's getting instantiated and by default the key is pressed W, then he's moving forwards without, well, pressing anything. Okay, last but not least, we are going to create another method and we call this public void, or let's do it private, of course, private void and check input. Okay. In this method, we are going to check which keys are we pressing. So to start with, we are going to create a first if statement. So if true, if input dot get key up, no, get key down, excuse me, and then our key code dot W. So if this will be pressed, okay. If this will be pressed, then we can make sure, why is it not? Oh, interesting. Oh, get button down. Excuse me, get key down, not get button down. That's my mistake. So if the key W is pressed, then we can say pressed key is equal to keys.w. If we are not pressing the key, okay, so else if, input dot get key down dot key code dot w else if then press key is equal dot keys dot none. So we don't want to hit any other key. Well, you can make it different. So, but for the beginner tutorial, I would say we need to hit the key multiple times. In a later video, well, probably the video after that, we are going into rotational data and how we can improve this movement script. So let's copy this and let's make it for W, A, just change the values right here. Paste it and then make it for S. Or change it. And again for D. So now we can move left, right, backwards and forwards. Perfect. But now we need to always check which key is pressed. So therefore we are going into our update method and type in check input. Simple as that, right? All right. So as next we are going into our network send method, since we want to send the press key over the network. So therefore we are going to create a new package which will be called C key input. All right, then let's create the packet. So create a new public static void and call it send key input. As a parameter, we do need, of course, an input manager keys and call this press key. Awesome. So now let's create the packet, which will be now, well, you should be able to create it blind now. So buffer, byte buffer, buffer equals new byte buffer parameter of 4. And then we are going to create a buffer, write integer 32, call it int, client packets dot c input. And as next, we are sending the information of the press key. So buffer dot write byte, byte, and we pass in the press key. Okay, then we can say network config dot socket dot send data, buffer data, and buffer dot head. And don't forget, last but not least, buffer dot dispose. Okay, now we have set up our package. Now go back to our input manager. And our input manager at the very last line, we are calling the send method. So network send dot send key input and our press key. Perfect. Okay. Normally we should basically attach the script to our player. But somehow now we have to make sure that the script, the input manager, only gets attached to our own player. So therefore, we need to change our packet welcome message as well. So in this case, after our message buffer read string, or before that, we are going to get our packet, our connection ID from the server. So which means int connection ID is equal to buffer.readin32. Okay. So basically, now in our network manager, right there, we are going to create a new variable. We're going to create a public static static int and call this my connection ID. Okay. So this connection ID will be necessary so we don't activate our movement when another player is moved, okay? So go back to network receive, and then at the end we can say, well, basically we can delete a network message sent ping. We don't need it anymore. We can delete the debug log message since we know now that we are getting information from our server. So now we can say network manager dot my connection ID is equal to connection ID. Later on, when we go to the server side, we are going to change that as well. Okay, perfect. Now we can say in our packet instantiate network player, we are just instantiating the raw player. Simple as that. Okay, but now we are making an if statement. So if connection ID is equal to network manager dot my connection ID, okay, if this is the same, well, basically we go back to the network manager since it's instantiated. We are going to create a public int my connection ID since it is a singleton class, and go back to our network receive and just change it to network manager dot instance dot my connection ID. The same we are doing here, instance my connection ID. So if connection ID is equal to my connection ID, okay, then basically we are doing something. What we could do. We go into instantiate network player and go making a bool. So bool is my player. Okay. So now we can create a if statement right here. So if is my player, okay, if is my player, then we say go dot add component, and then we are adding our input manager to this game object. If not, then basically do nothing. So, and now we can say if connection ID equals network manager instance my connection ID, then we say is my player, or equals to true, because it is my local player. And else we say network manager instance.instantiate network player connection ID equals to false. Therefore, we are going to instantiate another player, which is not our local player. Simple as that. Perfect. Now we are going on to our server side. So open up your server. And within our server, we are going straight into our network send method, so we don't forget it. In our welcome message packet, we are adding our buffer.write integer 32, and we are writing our connection ID. Awesome. Now it's getting interesting. So how we actually will be able to move the player on the server side. So first of all, we are going into our network receive method, and we are going to add C key input. Okay. To create our receiving packet. To do that, well, pretty much simple. Create a new method, call it private static void packet key input. The parameters as usual, int connection ID, ref byte array data. Okay, now read out the package. So byte buffer equals new byte buffer data. Now, what we are sending, a simple byte with a key in it. So byte key is equal to buffer.readbyte, and that's it. Now we can buffer.dispose. Excuse me, I need to turn down the volume of my phone really quick. So buffer.dispose. And then we have to make sure that we're actually doing something. In this case, we are going to create a new method, which we are typing in here right now. So on the server, we are going to create an input manager as well. That's why we can say input manager dot try to move, which will be our method. And then we are passing in the connection ID. And of course, another parameter of the input manager dot key and key. Okay, this will be our method we are calling, which we are going to create right away. Awesome. So let's go and create a new class and call this class, as we already said, input manager. Okay. So first of all, make this class a public class. And now let's go to the client and copy over our input manager enum, because we need that as well. Go back to the server and pass it in right here. Awesome. So now let's create our method try to move. So public static void try to move, and remember our parameters we did set up. So we do need an int of a connection ID, and we do need a keys dot key. Awesome. And now let's check our network receive, and there you go. One mistake, because it's called keys and not key. And yeah, our method is getting now called input manager. And of course, make sure that you actually add the package to the packet router. So c input and packet dot key input underscore key input. Okay, let's go back to the input manager and actually make the player moving. So within our player class, we have nothing basically. Okay, we have nothing, which makes sense. Now, what we are doing right now is we are getting the vector 3 data from Unity into our server project. So therefore, we are going to references and we are adding a new nugget package. First time in my tutorials adding a new nugget package. And now we are typing in the search bar, numerics. Numerics is a, is it numerics? Yeah, numerics is basically something from the system runtime. As you can see here, it is system runtime numerics. And what it does basically, it gives you everything Unity is using. So Unity is using this system, but differently. So you have quaternions, you have vector 3, vector 4, vector 2, and anything else. So click system runtime numerics, which already has 47 million downloads because it's from Microsoft itself, and hit install. Now a window should appear where you're going to accept it, allow it, let it install. So you have the reference of numerics right in here. As you can see, system.numerics. And now go back to the input manager and type in using system.numerics. Simple as that. Now within the player class, we are going to create our first vector 3. So now you can type in public vector 3, as you can see, and we call this position. Okay. Now go back to the input manager. And now we are making the player move. So we are saying, of course, we are needing numerics, so using system.numerics. Now create a variable and call this vector 3, which will be our temp position. Is equal to game manager playlist connection ID dot position. So now we are making a simple check. So if key is equal to keys.none, then we are going to return, since we don't want to move further. And now we are going to create a local variable. So we are going to say player is equal to game manager player list and connection ID. Okay. So now we are getting into all our if statements and our calculations. So if key is equal to keys.w, then we want to move the player forward, which basically means our temp position dot x plus equals our game manager dot, well, we don't have the variable yet, but dot our player speed. Okay. Our player speed we are going to create right now. So we can say in our game manager, public static float, and we say player speed is equal to 0.1 float. Well, that should be fairly enough to move the player. Going back to our input manager, and the same, we are just copying and pasting, the same will be also for the z-axis, okay? Which basically means when we are later on turning the player around, then we are moving on both axes, x and z-axis. Simple as that. Okay. Last but not least, we are going to create an else if statement. So else if key is equal to keys.s. Okay, so let's copy and paste this just below. And instead of plus equals, because we are moving backwards, we are going to minus equals. Simple as that. Another else if statement for the key, let's take A this time. Now it's getting tricky. Now we are moving not on the x-axis anymore, but on the z-axis, because we are moving left. So minus x-axis and plus the z-axis. Okay, as next, we are actually going to create for the key D. There you go. So with the key D, we want basically move to the right side. So we are doing the opposite. So plus equals and minus equals. Perfect. Now basically after that, there will come our collision detection system, which we are going into. Now take care. After we have done the movement system, okay? I'm planning on doing two videos of movement system. Now, this time, the raw movement. The next video will be with rotational data, where you are walking with the mouse and stuff like that. And after that, we are going into server-side physics, collision detection, and all that stuff. Then it's getting interesting. So make sure you subscribe or you missed that. Okay. So now we can say, player dot position is equal to temp position, right? And last but not least, we can basically say game manager dot player list connection ID dot position is equal to temp position. Well, basically, we're just making it like that because we don't. We don't need that. Okay, so now we are going into our network send method. No, we are not going into our network send method. We are doing it right after. After that, so after we are moving the player, we need to send it to everyone, right? So that's why we are going to say network send dot send player move. Don't worry, we are going to create this method in a second. We want to send the connection ID as well, so we know which player is moving. Then we are saying player no So we are going to copy game manager player list connection ID position dot x comma dot y comma dot z. And that's it. Now we are getting a huge error, but I don't mind. So let's go back to the network send and create the move packet. So S player move. Now scroll down and let's create the method. So public static void send player move. We need an int connection ID. We do need a float x. We do need a float y, and we do need a float z. Okay, now let's create a packet. Byte buffer buffer equals new byte buffer with the parameter of 4. Buffer dot write in 32 int server packets dot s player move. And now we are writing the connection ID. So write in 32 connection ID. And last but not least, we are sending the the positional data. So buffer dot write single. We are doing write single because single is a float. So that's why write single x. Duplicate it with Control D, do Y and Z. And now go for network config dot socket dot send data to all buffer dot data and buffer dot head. And don't forget buffer dot dispose. Awesome. Now we are able to send the player move after we're getting the input from the player itself. So now let's go back to the client. And actually on the client, on the network receive data, we need to make sure that we are moving the player on the client as well. Okay. So therefore, add the packet again as player move. And now scroll down and create the method to it to read out the data. So private static void packet player move ref byte array data. Okay, now read the data out. So byte buffer buffer equals new byte buffer of data and then our int connection ID is equal to buffer.read int 32. And then we are saying float x is equal to buffer.readSingle. And the same we are doing with Control D 2 times and just change the value to z and y. Okay, and last but not least, we are going to buffer dispose and actually move our player. So to move our player, we are going into our game manager instance.playerList, getting our connection ID, our player object, which we don't have yet. We need to go to our player object, or do we have, wait a second. Do we have, oh yeah, even better. So we can say transform.position equals to new vector 3. And then we're just passing in our x, y, and z value. So a simple check before we are doing this, okay? We want to make sure, so if not in game manager.instance.playerList.containsKey of our connection ID. So if this person is not there in our list, then return, okay? Because we cannot move a game object which is not there. But if he's there, then move the player. So no matter what. Okay, that should be everything right now. I hope really, like for sake of this tutorial, that everything is correct, which I did set up. So let's see, we have a first error. Could it be that because it's not in the asset folder? Yeah, there you go. So drag and drop the input manager into the asset folder, else it won't get recognized by Unity for some reason. And there you go. Okay, let's make a simple, a simple test. So start the server. Server is started. Minimize that and now start the client. So what should happen now is basically we're getting instantiated and we should be able to move. So hit play. And we see, nothing. We are seeing nothing because we basically not sending a message back to the server from the client. So go back to the client, go into our network send, and within our send ping, within our network receive, our packet welcome message, we need to send actually a method back so the server knows, okay, excuse me. So network send, send ping, and that's it. Okay. So let's go and restart the server real quick. Server's restarted. Let's go to the Unity client. And now hit play. So what happens now? The player is right there. And now if we press W, the player should move. But he cannot move because we actually on the client not listening to the player packet move, right? So let's go copy that in our packet router on the client, say S player move and our packet player move. It was a long work day, so excuse me for that. And I'll go back to the server, start the server again. Let's go back to the client. And let's start the game. Okay, so the player is here, and now we are able to move the player in every four directions, as you can see. Awesome. There you go. Sadly at all that the player is basically keep moving happening because the reason right there is in our client, I did a little mistake. I'm pretty sure you already figured it out. In our check input method, we basically saying that else if input messenger get key down, then it says keys.none, but it has to say get key up. Okay, so if the player get the key up, then basically everything is set to none. So let's copy that, pass it in right here, right there, and right there. Okay, and we need to remove this line if press keys equals none return in our check input method. So finally, remove that. Close the server, restart the server. Let's go to the Unity client. And then hit the play button again. And now we should be able to move with little steps, as you can see. As soon as you hit the key up, then the player stops walking. Awesome. Now you successfully can move the player over the network and the information gets stored by the server itself. To make the ultimate test, we are going to build this project and open up two clients. Okay, so close the server, start the server again, and then build and run the project. So let's see how long this takes actually in Unity. Yeah, it's going quite fast, as you can see. So basically, we are opening up one client as a build and one client in the editor and see basically if we are moving on other clients as well through the server. So open up Unity, hit play, and let's see what happens. So both players are getting initialized and instantiated, and now we can move. And as you can see, the left player, so basically player one, is not moving, but player two is moving on both clients. Okay, awesome. And now we are moving player one, and as you can see, he's also moving on, on the second client. Simple as that. So, yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you learned something. So now you will be able to actually create your own FPS game while already moving the player over the network and everyone can see it. And yeah, thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to leave a comment, leave a like, join my Discord server, check my homepage. I updated the network DLL file as well, which will go open source very soon. Once I sorted out a few bugs, and then we are good to go. In the next video, we are going to talk about rotation and how we actually add the rotation into the player's movement, since we just can move in four directions right now, as you can see. But yeah. That will we see in the next video. Thank you for watching, guys, and see you soon. Bye.